skal lige være klar.
All right, we are live here from Copenhagen Tech Festival in Kødbyen in Copenhagen, and together with me I have Thomas Madsen-Mygdal, who's actually the man behind the whole setup. He is the originator and the founder. So Thomas, thank you so much for showing up and kicking us off, because it's just a few hours ago that you kicked off the whole festival.
Yeah.
So I guess you're a bit relieved now and happy.
It all seems to be working.
Oh, that's fine. So for the people out there that doesn't know what Copenhagen Tech Festival is all about, could you just give them like a short introduction to the whole setup here?
Sure, yeah. Tech Festival is a new global technology festival for progressive human societal technology. So we started 2 years ago, back when sort of the tectonic plates of tech was changing, with a very progressive agenda. I think, yeah, now it's really starting to be a melting pot for this new conversation and new direction in technology. So we're city based, we're in the city, not in a convention center. We're very open, it's very accessible for everyone to participate.
A lot of noise.
A lot of noise, also a lot of action going on. It's the real world, right? It's not a, you know, it's not a simulated world, or, you know, it's the real deal with all that it entails.
Exactly. We just had a truck coming by. So Thomas, yeah, I guess one of the themes behind the festival is that we need to take more responsibility about the technology that we develop. We need to do it in a sustainable way, so it actually take all the humans into consideration, right?
Yeah.
So we just don't develop out of there. And
exactly. And
you have this ability to get a lot of great people to kind of show up. And can you mention a few of the names that you personally are looking forward to talking with and hearing at this festival this year?
Oh yeah. I mean, there's so many interesting people. I think it's really, we take another truck here.
Yeah. We're in the middle of the parking lot, so that's why there's so much noise.
We take a big garbage truck here.
Exactly.
Also. Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, TechFest, I think, you know, I just met somebody that attended a festival I did many, many years ago, and he said, like, why does it need to be so big? And I think it's kind of because that's tech is so big nowadays,
yeah,
right?
Is, yeah.
So I think really the width of the event is really sort of what, you know, we have more than 300 speakers from around the world, more than participants from more than 50 countries. So so I think there's something about that kind of, that there's something for everyone.
Yeah.
Obviously, we in the evenings, we've really designed it to be around a shared experience.
Yeah.
There are so many festivals nowadays that have 5-6 big stages, but nobody hears the same.
No.
So we really designed it like we have this sort of communal dinner around the main stage area, and then we all listen to the keynotes for 1 hour at 8 o'clock in the evening,
yeah,
open air. So there are some amazing keynotes there. Chris Messina, who early web sort of a pioneer, invented the hashtag, his claim to fame. We have Jimmy Wales, the co-founder of Wikipedia,
yeah,
this amazing icon,
yeah,
that I think is something we just kind of take for granted. I was actually in a conversation with my kids where I realized that for them, this is like, Wikipedia is like, you know,
it has been there always.
It's always been there, and you know, it's so fundamental, yeah, to, and you know, you remember all the friction that,
exactly,
was 15, 20 years about whether it could work or whether it was correct or not, and it was like the, from the establishment. And also, I think for us, we're talking a lot about this sort of that part of the issues in tech is also that in we've been here 25 years or so or more and with digital technologies,
yeah,
but we've created little new institutions,
yeah,
and you know, everything is very commercial, and then there's sort of government, but no real sort of new institutions, where Wikipedia is probably the only
them, yeah,
true icon,
yeah,
of our times that is non-profit and,
yeah,
you know, one of the top 10 websites in the
and
world.
And he's on stage Friday night, right?
That's Friday night,
yeah,
8 o'clock, yeah,
yeah.
So, yeah.
That's
so there's
that's pretty much open for everybody to come and listen to, right?
Yes, you kind of need a wristband, but I'm not sure we're checking that much.
No,
so,
but yeah, you can still buy them and they're cheap. It's 200 krona.
It's, yeah,
like
40 euro for
40
a ticket,
euro,
yeah,
yeah,
that gives you access to everything,
yeah, exactly.
So that way we're also, I mean, obviously also working with Charlie Tango and many other great partners in terms of making it accessible and
yeah,
something that anyone working in tech,
yeah,
not only the CEOs,
yeah,
you know,
exactly,
but it's that it really touches all of us, so
yeah,
that's the idea.
That's great. And one last thing I wanted to talk with you about is that 2 years ago, one of the things you did was you gathered 150 people to kind of create something called the Copenhagen Letter. And then the year after, you gathered another 150 people to create the Copenhagen Catalog.
Yeah.
And this year you have once again gathered a group of people to create something called the Copenhagen Pledge.
Yeah.
Can you talk a little about kind of this triangular of documents and or concepts?
Trilogy we're doing here.
Yeah,
so
yeah, exactly.
So I mean, one of the things we're trying to do with Techfestival is really sort of creating output and impact, so that it's not only 48 hours of conversations and solutions and discussions, but that we create output and artifacts that can travel the world and impact. And also it's just a great design criteria for really getting people to engage, right?
So, yeah.
So we'll once again put together our think tank, 150 people from around the world, all kinds of, you know, genders, backgrounds, skills, ages. A very diverse group of people, and for 24 hours they're being put in a room to create the Tech Pledge, which is the assignment this year.
Yeah.
So sort of completing the trilogy, so we're writing sort of a very personal pledge that we can all take.
Yeah. Is it for personal matter, or is it also for companies to take the pledge in a way?
It's written to be signed by an individual,
okay.
Or it will be.
So
far we only know that it's going to say I pledge too.
Okay.
That's all we know.
Yeah.
And then everything else will be co-created and discussed and shaped in the think tank.
Yeah.
So we imagine as something, you know, a developer, a programmer, a CEO,
okay.
A founder, somebody writing code in a bank would want to sign and sort of be aspirational.
Yeah.
And then I'm sure at some point it could also be a company.
Yeah, because I know that Milestones worked on something called the Copenhagen Clause, which is not something that originated from you, but kind of sprung out of the work that was done.
Yeah.
And that's more like a corporate thing, right?
Exactly. So, I mean, I think we want to kind of complete the trilogy with the letter. It was sort of this urgent call for a new direction in tech for the first year. So we wanted to do something that's even more personal this year.
Yeah.
But I think you're highlighting, I mean, it's so interesting, you know, Milestone, a big part of the Canon group, has done this amazing work on starting to implement this, a lot of these things, in where it's not, you know, about soft topics, but it's really down to earth in how they do business, who they conduct business with, what use of their software technology they allow. They've already terminated the partnership with one of the biggest Chinese partners they had because they were not satisfied with how their software was used, that it was you know, according to UN standards and etc. So I mean, and that's the interesting thing. I think that starting to be real sort of impact on the business side, on a lot of the work being done here, because it is the zeitgeist in many ways. So
if you're out there and you didn't know that this was taking place, you should just, you know, come around, get to Kødbyen. There's a lot happening here. There's summits, there are talks, there are a lot of things happening for the next 3 days, actually. We just started.
Yeah.
And we'll see each other around the setup.
We will.
Thank you so much for stopping by and kicking us off.
Welcome to Tech Festival, Tim.
Perfect.